We'll see what is the phytotomy. So in last time we were discussing about this mutational operations like repulsion, extraction, okay, and so many other things, okay, version and other manipulative techniques for pervagenate delivery. But suppose the size of the fetus is so large, okay, or in sometimes size is normal, but the extremities are bent in such a way that you cannot trace any one of the limb or head or something like that. So in that way, and then if fetus is died, okay, if it is died, then the best way is to perform phytotomy, reduce the size, and then take out the fetus, because mother is more important. Okay. So in that way, we actually perform phytotomy. So it is one of the part of pervagenate delivery, but it is a kind of midway between surgery and normal pervagenate delivery. Okay. So what is phytotomy? By definition, if you see phytotomy, previously it was said as a embryotomy. Okay. But now the name has changed, and then the universally accepted name is phytotomy. So phytotomy is referred as dissection of fetus, okay, into two or more parts within the uterus or vagina, okay, in order to reduce the size of the fetus so that the delivery can be done through pervaginal, through birth canal, okay. So that is the definition of phytotomy, right? So we can perform phytotomy in various species, especially large animal. Okay, we can perform in cow, in buffalo, mare, and even in small animals. But the best subject is cow or buffalo, because they are very steady. They can, pain perception, and they are a kind of calm animal, right? The thing is, you can perform this phytotomy in mare also, but in case of mare, we have two problems, right? In cow, we can use, or buffalo, we can use phytotomy very nicely. But in case of mare, there is two very big problem. That first, so the moment you start manipulating per vaginal, you are, because in phytotomy, you are introducing some instrument inside the vagina, okay? And then you are putting wire over the fetus, and then you are cutting the, so you are doing a lot of manipulation pervaginally. But in case, you can do it normally in case of cow and buffalo, but when it comes to mare, when you do manipulation pervaginum, the tendency of mare vagina is that it gets inflamed or it gets edematous very quickly, very, very rapidly. Okay. So the thing is, you are manipulating so that the size of the fetus can be reduced, so that it can be taken out through birth canal. But if suppose edema developed in the birth canal, so it will be very difficult, right? You cannot take out the fetus. So the major problem of use of phytotomy in case of mare is that the vaginal canal, birth canal, vaginal mucosa gets inflamed or edematous, therefore reduces the size of the birth canal, right? So that is one such major issue in case of mare. Then second is that mare horse species are very a kind of active and alert species, okay? So there is some word used there, but you will not be able to understand that. So for making you understand, I can use that the horse cannot tolerate much of the manipulation or pain, okay, as compared to cattle and buffalo. In fact buffalo can bear lot of pain. Even if you are manipulating through vagina for even hours together, the buffalo will be calm only, it will not react much. Cow will be a little reactive, but mare means it will go into the state of hyper excitement. Okay, so these animals, this mare is not a calm animal. They will show hyper excitement, ataxia will develop, and so many things. Okay, so again, keeping the animal calm through the procedure, entire procedure is very, very important. Okay. So these are the two very important points, because why we are not using much in case of mare, but in case of cow and buffalo, it is quite easily used. Okay. So that is one. Okay. So when we should decide that yes, time of phytotomy has reached. Okay. So first of all, you are doing mutational operations like repulsion, okay, version, traction, so many things, right? But when you are doing traction, you had catch hold the maybe limbs or head or something, and you are using traction. So it's not that you use traction for hours together, okay? Just that if suppose it is a case of fetal-maternal disproportionation, you can use traction for about 5 minutes or so, right? More than 5 minutes means then you have to, if suppose the it's not yielding means you are using continuous traction, the position, presentation, everything has corrected, okay, has been corrected by you, and then you are using traction. So it should come within a minute, okay, if proper force is applied. So, but if it is taking more than 5 minutes, means there is some problem, and therefore if suppose the fetus is dead, so now immediately you have to perform either fetotomy or cesarean section. Okay, suppose if the disposition is faulty, suppose the lateral deviation of head is there, or ventral deviation of head is there, or limbs flexion is there, so then you can take even 15 minutes or so. But even though if it is not coming out after correction and all, then you have to shift into this phytotomy or cesarean section immediately. Okay, you cannot wait for hours together. Okay, so when it comes to phytotomy, so it is there are two type of phytotomy is described in literatures. The one is subcutaneous phytotomy, and then second is percutaneous phytotomy. Okay, so subcutaneous is a older version, okay, initial version, in which subcutaneous means they used to make cuts, okay, they used to keep the skin intact, and other viscera and everything used to be taken out, okay, only the one limb for anchoring they used to keep, right? So there is advantage, there is disadvantage as well. Suppose advantage is that suppose the fetal skin is intact, of course you will see in the next coming slides. So if fetal skin is intact, means you are doing any manipulation, but you are avoiding the chance of endometrium to get injured, okay, because fetal skin is there. So you are doing anything, you suppose evisceration, or you are taking out the limbs or anything, so you are doing within the skin, fetal skin, so you are not damaging the maternal tissue, that is endometrium, okay. But it is very, you know, cumbersome process, it takes a long, and now it is a old fashioned, so we don't use this subcutaneous, okay. So in place of subcutaneous, we have percutaneous phytotomy, okay. So you'll see what is percutaneous, what is subcutaneous, okay. So when it comes, look, as I told you, it is earlier version of phytotomy, 18th century, okay. So what some by use of knife, chisel, hoop for, you know, removing internal organs and all. So what we usually do during the subcutaneous phytotomy, we used to remove the fetal part symmetrically, okay, but skin of the fetus is attached, okay. We usually, like I said, we usually put one or maybe distal or four limb attached, okay, for the anchoring process, because if suppose entire bone or entire things have been taken out, means there is no point of traction, you cannot hold any tissue, okay. So for that, one limb used to be left there, like and then I told you that advantage, biggest advantage is that the skin is intact. Okay, so whatever manipulation you are doing under the skin of fetus, so you are not damaging the endometrium of dam. Okay, now coming to the percutaneous fetotomy. So it is developed in 20th century, right? Technique in percutaneous fetotomy is that is it involves the dissection, cutting of fetus, okay, through skin. So skin is not intact in this way. So cutting of entire fetus involving the skin, muscles, ligament, and every tissue through the use of braided wire. Okay. So one advantage is that it is faster, it is rapid than subcutaneous, because subcutaneous we are taking much longer time. So even though the cow and buffalo is calm animal, okay, the edema doesn't set up early as compared to mare, but still you cannot do this procedure for very long period, right? So if it is the fetotomy is performed rapidly, then it is very advantage for this method. Okay, so that is one such advantage over the subcutaneous, that it is faster. Okay, now what are the indications what are the indications why we should use fetotomy? We discussed a little bit earlier, but now we again, suppose feto maternal disproportion is there, a fetus is oversized. So oversized means now the entire fetus has grown over, or its bony growth or muscle growth is so that the pelvic inlet is not that much developed. Okay, suppose the animal, the cow is still growing, so pelvic inlet, the bony pelvis is still growing, but the fetus inside is fully grown. So it is not, the size of the fetus is bigger than the pelvic inlet. So now it is impossible to assist or to do this pervaginal delivery, because bony pelvis is fixed. Look, muscles and other things, they can compress, but bony pelvis means bones cannot be compressed. They are fixed. Okay. So pelvic inlet is fixed like that. So suppose the fetus size is over. Okay. Maternal bony pelvis is not that much big, or the dam or mother is still growing. So when bony pelvis and pelvic canal is still a narrower one. So in that case, you can reduce the size. The ultimate aim is to reduce the size of the fetus. Fetus ka size hume reduce karna hai, agar oversize hai to, right? Then second, to correct the malposition. Suppose malposition, presentation position, posture is normally what we do, we use mutation means maybe retropulsion version, everything to correct the position. But suppose the position is not at all, it cannot be corrected. Okay, so the best is to cut the entire arm any bone which is involved, or deviation, flexion, or anything is there. So for that we can use fetotomy. Okay, suppose hip lock position is there, so both the hip bones are attached fixed to the pubis of the maternal pelvic canal. In that case also we have to bisect the hip bone in order to relieve the condition. Okay, suppose fetus is normal, dam is normal, dam is fully grown, fetus size is okay, it can be taken out through the pelvic inlet and all. But suppose cervix dilation was not proper, cervix is not dilating, we had given we had tried mechanical dilation, we had given some muscle relaxant, something which dilates the cervix, but still the cervix dilation is not as good as it should be. Okay, So then you have to reduce the size. For that, phytotomy has to be done. Then one more condition, suppose there is monster fetus. Monster fetus means some fetus which are abnormally grown, or like if we take one such example, like schistosomus reflexus. Okay, so it is not overgrown, but the thing is vertebral canal is bent. It will be like V shape. Okay, the viscera means intestine, liver, stomach, everything will be out of the abdomen. So the fetus will be arranged in such way that it cannot be taken out through vagina. Okay, so for that case also you have to reduce the size. So in that case also you have to reduce the size. Now, what are the phytotomes? So in initial days, the phytotome, we learn about that UH model. Okay. So it is two barrel flat tube one. Okay. Then now what commonly used in our obstetrical practices, Thijssen's phytotome. So it is double barrel and have some Swedish modification. So when you come to the college, you will see the actual phytotome. Okay, but right now this is double barrel, this is one barrel, this is second barrel. Okay, so these are handlers. So we can have this S shape, or we can have some other shapes are also available. This is wire. Okay, wires are. This is wire introducer. Okay, so these are the protective tubes. Okay, so we'll show you right here. Okay, once you are in the college, we'll show you all these things. Okay, now we'll quickly see what is the subcutaneous phytotomy, right? So for one example, I am giving you this three photographs. So for example, we want to remove the forelimb, and the fetus is there in anterior longitudinal presentation, right? So that's how we have to make cut. First of all, anchoring in pastern joint. Okay, then you have to make a cut. Look, so skin is detached. Okay, and now in third position, the other, this exposed bone and muscle. Okay, skin is intact, skin is kept right here. Now anchoring is provided, and now it will be pulled, and the entire this forelimb will be taken out without skin. You need to see this without skin. So skin is right here. Okay, so now we'll see percutaneous phytotomy, which is most that is commonly used nowadays. So percutaneous phytotomy, before going to the actual procedure, we will see what are the medications used. So before going for manipulation, you can use NSAIDs, okay, to reduce inflammatory changes and all. Okay, we can use broad spectrum antibiotic, because you are using some manipulation, even though you are protective, you have used protective gloves and all, but still there are chances of infection through instrument to the mother. So that's how you have to give NSAID, you have to give, muscle relaxants. You can use this broad spectrum antibiotics. Okay. And don't forget to give epidural anesthesia. You know how to give epidural anesthesia, and what are the drugs used for epidural anesthesia, right? And what are the indication as well? The best indication is reduces the pain sensation and then straining. Okay, so second most important thing is lubrication. We have to provide ample amount of lubrication. You can use petroleum based lubricants like Vaseline and all. Okay, or fluid based. Okay, so a very good one is polyethylene polymer, but if it is not available, in our times we used this liquid paraffin as well. Okay, the best is, in our case, best is CMC, carboxymethyl cellulose, can be used very effectively. It is very, very good lubricant. Okay, and especially obstetric and manipulation, it is the best one, right? So lubrication is over. Now the thing is our safety. So obstetrician or any doctor which is performing this entire thing, they are very likely to get infected. So especially this listeria and salmonella, okay, and other infections. So the it is advisable that, because you are handling some this dead fetus, okay, so dead fetus means definitely the rotting has started, right? So there are every chance that you may get infection. So because you are using your hands and all, so protective this full arm sleeves, plastic disposable full arm sleeve is essential when you are using these things. Few people in the field condition, they used to remove the sleeves. They used to complain that when we use sleeves, it is slippery and we are not able to perform our work. But it is not at all advisable. Okay, you use good quality sleeves. It won't, of course, slippery will be the, it will be slippery, but you will be able to perform your duty properly. But negligence will lead to serious medical conditions. So avoid this. Use this full arm sleeve. Okay. So this is just a representation how you make cuts. Because now what we are discussing is percutaneous phytotomy, means you are cutting entire skin, bone, muscle, every damn thing, right? So these are the number of cuts. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Okay, I'll show you afterwards one by one. So if you are doing total phytotomy, you need 6 cuts. Okay, come, we'll see one example. Okay, so we are going to perform total phytotomy in fetus which is present in anterior longitudinal presentation. So first part is head. As I told you, head is the biggest part, and it is most difficult to take out. Okay, so we are going to amputate the head. Okay, first of all, you have to thread the fetotum, both the barrels. Okay, you have to put thread in both the barrels of fetotum, right? You have to make a loop like this. Okay, you had introduced from here, you had made outside only, you will make a small loop, and then again you have to place the thread, and then there will be a loop. Now once you had made the loop, you have to put that loop in your hand. You have to progress your hand along with the barrel inside the vagina. Okay, and you have to place the loop over the fetal head. And what will be the position? It will be behind the ears. Okay, suppose you have lots of area is there, you can manipulate further. So the best thing is, you put the barrel, this barrel, you put the barrel between the, this, you see the mandible is there, okay? So you can put the barrel of head, this one is head, this is the barrel. So you can put the head of the fetotum, okay, in between the, mandibles, okay? Especially caudal to posterior part, okay? Suppose you don't have much space there. So now you can put like this laterally. Best is to put between the mandibles. But now suppose space is not there, so you can put laterally as well. So this is the condition. This is how you have to put the loop. And now you will use two handles. Okay. And like aapne kabhi dekha ho, ghar mein kaise wo, जिनके पास बहुत ज्यादा वो मक्खन निकालने वाले लोग होते हैं ना, जब घर में मक्खन निकालते हैं लोग, तो उसमें आप देखो चर्निंग करते हैं, चर्निंग, एक हाथ से पहले ढीला किया, दूसरे वाले को खींच लिया, फिर दूसरे वाले को ढीला किया, पहले वाले को खींच लिया, राइट? सेम थिंग हैपेंस हियर आल्सो, यू हैव टू डू चर्निंग। जैसे ही आप एक एक वायर को खींचोगे, दूसरे को ढीला करोगे, दूसरे को फिर खींचोगे, पहले को ढीला करोगे, तो यहाँ पे फ्रिक्शन पैदा होगा और ये मसल बोन एवरीथिंग विल कट इनटू द पीसेस। नाउ कमिंग टू द सेकेंड कट, सेम प्रेजेंटेशन, सेकेंड कट, ओके। नाउ द चेन इज प्लेस्ड ओवर द पास्टर्न रीजन फर्स्ट, देन लेग विल बी पुल्ड, एक्सटेंशन आप करोगे, ओके। अब पहला तो पास्टर्न रीजन में आपने चेन लगा के उसको खींच लिया, ओके। अब क्या करोगे, वायरिंग, पीटोटोम की वायरिंग की आपने, ओके, लूप बनाया, ओके, और अपने हाथ से उस लूप को पकड़ के आप अंदर लेके जाओगे, ओके। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आप क्या करोगे, उसी लूप को जहां पे चेन लगी हुई है वहीं पे एक बार फिक्स कर लोगे, ठीक, और फीटोटोम को अंदर लेटरली खींच के लेके जाओगे ताकि लूप बड़ा बने, ओके। और उसके बाद एक बार लूप फीटोटोम का हेड पहुंच गया ओरिजिनल पोजीशन पे स्कैपुला के पास, देन यू हैव टू गाइड द लूप, ओके, टू सिट इन दैट स्कैपुला बिहाइंड द स्कैपुला रीजन। आपको फोटोग्राफ देखोगे तो आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा, दिस वे, ओके। सो लास्ट थर्ड कट वॉज देयर, देन फोर्थ कट, आपके दोनों, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल हेड का कटिंग हुआ, फिर वन बाई वन आपके दोनों फोर लिम्ब कटे, स्कैपुला के पास आपने लूप बना के पहले आपने एंकरिंग की पास्टर्न जॉइंट में, एक खींच के रखा, उसके बाद वहीं पे एंकरिंग करके आपने लूप पहनाया, फीटोटोम को अंदर की तरफ स्लाइड करके लेके गए और उसका हेड स्कैपुला के पास रखा, देन जहां पे आपने लूप को फंसाया था वहां से उसको डिटैच किया और स्कैपुला के अराउंड उसको किया, तो एक लिम्ब आपका कटा, ठीक है। ये सेम प्रोसीजर आप तीसरे कट में भी सेम प्रोसीजर अपनाओगे, ठीक है, दूसरे साइड में। तीन कट हो गए, तो अभी हेड चला गया प्लस दोनों शोल्डर चले गए, अब क्या बचा, थोरैक्स, ओके। तो चौथा कट कहाँ होगा, थोरैक्स के पास होगा, ओके। तो इसके लिए, थोरैक्स के लिए आपको एक क्रे शॉर्टलर हुक होती है, आप यहाँ पे आओगे तो आपको दिखाएंगे, उसके दोनों जॉ एक साथ पकड़ सकते हैं। तो पहले तो आप क्रे शॉर्टलर हुक को रिब्स में अटैच करवाओगे, ओके, राइट। उसके बाद एक चेन पास करोगे, ओके, वायर का लूप पास करोगे अपने हाथ से पकड़ते हुए, ओके, और इसको अराउंड द रिब आप द वे इट इज प्लेस्ड हियर, ठीक है, अराउंड द रिब आप उसको प्लेस करोगे, ओके, फीटोटोम को एडवांस करोगे, लूप को अंदर लेके जाओगे, ऑलरेडी आपने क्रे शॉर्टलर लगा के रखा है, दिस इज क्रे शॉर्टलर, ओके, फीटोटोम को आगे की तरह एडवांस करोगे और लास्ट रिब के पास जहां से रिब खत्म हो रही वहां पे आप अपना लूप प्लेस कर दोगे एंड देन चर्निंग विल स्टार्ट, ओके, फोर हो गया। उसके बाद अब आप थोरेक्स कट गया, रिब्स का एरिया पूरा कट गया, अब बचा क्या, लंबर एरिया बचा, हाइंड क्वार्टर बचा, तो लंबर एरिया को बाईपास नहीं कर सकते, बिकॉज अंटिल अनलेस यू कट दिस लंबर एरिया यू कैन नॉट रीच हाइंड क्वार्टर, द बेसिक एम इज टू रीच द हाइंड क्वार्टर, ओके। तो आप थोरैक्स काट लिया फिर भी आपके पास इतना टाइम, इतना वो नहीं होगा, हाथ इतना लंबा नहीं होगा कि आप हाइंड क्वार्टर में लूपिंग कर पाए, उसके लिए क्या करोगे, लंबर एरिया को काटोगे। सो लंबर एरिया में अराउंड द गर्थ आप ऐसे लूप प्लेस करोगे, सेम वही सिचुएशन जैसे आपने थोरैक्स में किया, क्रे शॉर्टलर अटैच किया, लूप बनाया और आगे की तरफ लेके गए, आगे की तरफ लेके गए और सेम वे में लंबर एरिया को भी आप कट करोगे। फिर सिक्स्थ कट विल बी ऑन हाइंड क्वार्टर द वे इट इज प्लेस्ड, यहाँ पे आप सिंगल थ्रेडिंग करोगे, ओके, लूप को अराउंड द पेल्विस, लुक अराउंड द पेल्विस आप लूप को प्लेस करके, और उसके बाद ठीक है, ये सेकेंड और ये थर्ड कट का है, ठीक है, लुक पहले आपने इस तरह से फिक्स किया, खींच के रखा, फिक्स किया, उसके बाद साइड से लेके गए स्लाइड करते हुए स्कैपुला के बगल में इस लूप को प्लेस किया, ओके, सो दैट्स हाउ द हाइंड क्वार्टर कैन बी सीवियर्ड. सो एक हाइंड क्वार्टर अलग हो गया, दूसरा हाइंड क्वार्टर अलग, राइट, सो दैट्स हाउ द फीटोटॉमी हैज टू बी परफॉर्म. क्लियर, ये एक पोजीशन का हुआ.